Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another tutorial. Today, we are going to take a look at spins. Whether in a hole or on the shoulder of a wave, there is nothing quite so satisfying as simply spinning around and around. The spin is one of those moves that is not only endlessly stylish, but has great utility for moving around the feature you're surfing, whether you got there deliberately or not. If you haven't yet got the hang of comfortably side surfing, then head back and check out that video first, before having a go at this. But once you can stably sit with the hull flat to the green water, there's no reason not to experiment with spinning. The first and most important aspect of the spin is knowing where to do it. Of course, you can expend a lot of effort and force a spin in most any hole, more or less, but your degree of success is likely to vary significantly, not to mention you will be expending a lot of energy. Far better to look for and use the power of the water to your advantage. What you want to look for is some weakness in the hole, or even a defined shoulder, where the predominant current is flowing downstream rather than re-entering the hydraulic. Once you know where you need to be, the next vital point is getting yourself there. A common error when spinning is not positioning correctly, either with too much of the boat in the downstream flow, or not enough of it. You want your body, which forms the effective axis of the rotation, to be sat exactly at the point where the recirculating current of the hole meets the downstream flow on the shoulder. If your body is too far back into the hole, the boat simply won't spin, whilst too much hull in the downstream flow will drag you off downriver. Finding this position, where the front half of the boat is naturally being taken up the pile while the body remains at the centre of the spin, is one of the hardest aspects of this move, and one that beginners will often seek to force by applying lots of strokes. While stroke placement can help you to align your kayak correctly, I think a better method is to reduce your strokes to a bare minimum, waiting and observing what the hole is naturally inclined to do to your boat. With a slow, cautious approach, you can even get away with using no strokes at all. But if you do feel the need, applying gentle pressure on the downstream blade, almost like a side-on rudder, is usually enough to hold you stationary, allowing you to make this observation. Now that you're in the right place, it's time to consider what your body is doing. We begin with the head, because that is the source of directional control in the spin. In much the same way as was described in the cartwheel tutorial, your head during the spin should mirror a ballerina doing pirouettes. Choose a marker upstream of you to focus on and keep your eyes on it, snapping your head around to look over your shoulder as soon as the bow of your kayak is facing downstream. With your head rotated ahead of the rotation in this way, your chest and torso will naturally want to follow, as will the hull of your boat. Moving down to the torso, you want to stay in that neutral, upright position that we discussed in the side surfing video. Remember, you want your body to function as the axis around which the boat is spinning. Next up, the hips and knees. This is where things start to get a bit more technical. As we established in the side surfing video, you want to keep your kayak's hull as close to the angle of the green water as you possibly can, without risking a flip. And that remains true during the spin. The hull should be practically flat onto the green water. But that gets complicated when your bow starts pointing downstream. At that stage in the spin, halfway through hopefully, you want to use your hips and knees to gently transition from edge to edge, keeping the upstream side of your kayak from loading with the green water. Hopefully it doesn't take too much imagination to see why that is undesirable. When you're first starting out with spins, you may feel the need to apply some strokes on the downstream side to aid the motion. But don't be tempted to put in too many, or try to force the spin to happen too quickly. Every hole will have a natural pace that it wants to spin you, so just go with it, applying those gentle downstream strokes just to keep you in the sweet spot. Once you've got the hang of that, perhaps try some clean spins using no paddle at all. It won't work out every time, but when it does, your friends are sure to be impressed.
Thank you very much for watching this tutorial video. I hope you found it enjoyable and informative. If you've been following any of my content and you're enjoying it, then please do consider subscribing. And if you feel like giving this a like, sharing it wherever you feel comfortable, that would be really hugely appreciated as well. It just helps these videos to go further and for more people to see and benefit from them. Thanks very much, and I'll see you in the next one. Woo!